Hello everybody, today we're going to have you a quick introduction to the Struers Tegramin. This is the Tegramin 30, which is the largest of our benchtop machines. We also have the Tegramin 25 and Tegramin 20, which have the 250 platen and of course the 200 mil platen. Now the first thing that stands out to me is the hood on this machine. This is used for a couple of reasons. Obviously it improves the safety for the operator, it reduces noise, and if you have an extractor attached, it will pull the fumes out into your extractor system. The machine itself is made from an aluminium based, cast aluminium. It gives it strength, light, and the body itself is a composite, again tough as steel, but a lot lighter. And of course, unlike steel, it doesn't rust. The new head has dual columns on it, which gives it a lot more rigidity. And of course, with the rigidity comes planarity. It also helps with the stock removal function, whereby you can use a specimen holder to remove the microns to 5 millimeters of stock. This machine also has the standard Struers interface, as you'll see on many of our other machines, our cutting machines and our mounting machines. So once you can use one of our machines, the others are relatively easy too. As well as demonstrating the machine today, we're also going to show you our three-step titanium method. Matt's now going to load on the first disc. And let's load up the carousel. This time, we're going to use sample louver plate, so we have individual pressure feet that come down on the sample. After 1 minute on our Mezzo diamond disc, which is specially formulated for titanium, we should get the planarity we need for the further operations. While the samples are cleaning, Matt's going to spin the excess water off the disc. The platen will spin at 600 RPM, and the water just spins off the side. It's a good way of keeping your disc clean and dry. Now the sample's clean, we're ready for stage two, which is some 9 micron on the plan cloth. Before we start, you'll notice that there's a rubber ring on top of the mover plate. This is so we can use the Lavamin, which is our automatic cleaning machine, which we'll show you in a short while. As we finish this last step, you will probably just be able to see the diamond slowly dripping. What's really good at the end of this is to make sure there's no excess diamond, is that when the machine stops, we have a sniff function which will pull back any diamond that's ready to drip, thus making sure we don't contaminate the cloth. Okay, off we go for cleaning again. Matt's taking it away now for cleaning, but you've probably noticed the button he used on the front of the machine to release the sample mover plate. The great thing about that is that that always comes back to the front, so you're not looking around searching for it. Just one of those nice little things that Struers do for you. So Matt's just going to pre-dose the machine with a little bit of OPS, get some of the cloth, get it nice and ready to go. There we go. Now we're going to load up and away we go for the final step, which is OPS, which will run 5 minutes, and we also have hydrogen peroxide in this mix as well, which is excellent for chemically cleaning the surface of the sample. The important thing here is that we're going counter-rotative on the disc, which ensures that we keep as much as we can of the OPS on the cloth and don't let it spin off, giving a really good finish. Here's a little tip, when you're doing the OPS, make sure that the dosing arm is pushed to the outside of the disc, because as the head moves contra, it pulls the samples in. But so if you have the dosing head in the middle of the cloth, it won't push it out to the sides. You don't want it there, you want it there. This is our Lavamin, the fully automatic cleaning system that you can use alongside your Tegramin. In fact, you can actually connect the two together. So the Lavamin sits next to the Tegramin and uses the same water supply. So Matt's just going to put a sample in and let it run on a very short cycle. It's the 1 minute cycle, which is great for after the plain grinding operation or diamond polishing. We have three cycles in total, the other two being a 1.5 minute one and then a 2 minute one, which you would probably use after OP polishing. The disc rotates inside a water-filled cabinet with ultrasonics at the same time cleaning the sample. Once it's finished its cycle, it will then spin at a very high speed while blowing compressed air into the system. So the lid automatically lifts when we've finished, and as you can see, we have some nice, clean samples.